My heart's been broke too long.
Hey YouTube, what's going on? Junior here, and I'm back again with another reaction video, back again with another viewer request. This one comes courtesy of James A, who's asked me to react to a song called Fiddler on the Green by Demons and Wizards. This band is a side project between Iced Earth founder and guitarist John Schaefer and Blind Guardian's lead vocalist. Oh, sick. I do love Blind Guardian. I think the vocals are really what makes the band for me. What makes the song special is the backstory. While Hansi was walking his dog at a small hometown in Germany, he witnessed a small boy dying after a car ran him over. A week later, another car hit a small girl and she also died in the same spot. The image he paints and the way he tries to make sense of the tragedy is really pure art, hashtag music with substance. Fiddler's Green is an assumed afterlife from 19th century maritime folklore. The interpretation in this song has the fiddler on the green represent the personification of death. Death is typically infallible, but in his first error, collects the life of a boy too early. To redeem himself, he later takes the life of a girl, allowing both souls to endure together for eternity. A very bittersweet story, tragic but sad and cute at the same time. I don't know, we'll just have to listen to it. I'm very excited for the song. I don't know too much about Iced Earth, but Blind Guardian is one of those kind of pioneering power metal acts that I really enjoy, so I'm anticipating it being a good one. I don't know. Thanks to James A for the suggestion. Everybody else, follow in their example. Leave your suggestions in the comments down below, and the next video could be yours. And yeah, that's about it. You know, let's just go. You know, I don't have anything to say. Already digging the clean guitars, of course.
Sad voices that call in our precious girl, she can't be gone. A bit of this morning, and daddy's stalling, went out and started a day. Wasn't there a dream last night, like a spring never ending? Still the water runs clear through my mind. On the field, I can see a fiddler, the fiddler on the green, and the sad boy. I took him to I. Would you mind if I take you?
I already love this song. Folk metal and anything that can, like, you can combine like folk stories, folklore, even fantasy inspired elements and bring it into music is something that I'm going to enjoy, especially when it's the production is just so clean, the voice is just so expressive, and these lyrics, you know, just really pulling at the old heartstrings here. Basically, this first verse talking about how the fiddler, as you can see, I guess, personified in this album art here, he goes out and collects this soul of a young girl, and he hears, like, the sad laments of the girl's family as she's dying or dies. But basically, he's asking her if she wouldn't mind coming with him, because he took a boy's life too early, and he wants him to have, I guess, a companion for eternity in the afterlife. I mean, it sounds great. It sounds amazing. I love it. Let's keep going. And we introduced some of those distorted guitars here as well, so.
Thank you. seemed bright. The air was clear. The air was clear. A trick of light turned red into green. She saw the eye. Her face was pale. Her body smashed. Her beauty's gone.
Okay, before we get too much into, like, the last instrumental bit at the end here. Man, what an awesome song. The lyrics seem to be done. The Take My Hand line where the rest of the instrumentation just kind of explodes, announces its presence for the rest of the song. Throughout the whole thing, beautiful use of, like, harmonies. The guy's voice, again, is very theatrical, which is something that I really enjoy. A lot of people, when they first get into, like, Blind Guardian, sometimes take an issue with his voice, but I've always found it to be so interesting and expressive that it never really bothered me. And in this song, it just suits the tone and the story so well. And, you know, just all the clean guitars and everything going on in the first two-thirds of the song, just, you know, just keeping it nice and simple, but very, again, so beautifully produced that it just is a perfect accompaniment for this entire story. It's just enjoyable. It's just very pleasant to listen to. Knowing the story behind it adds kind of bittersweet tinge in the airwaves. Take it. So that was Fiddler on the Green by Demons and Wizards, the side project / supergroup. What can I say? This song was aesthetically, of course, it was amazing. I like the lyrics, I like the vocal delivery. I liked the instrumentation. I liked everything about it. It was a very solid track. And even just, like, touching on the themes of the song and the idea, you know, that sort of sprung from this experience of seeing, like, a little boy who died by getting hit by a car, and then a week later the same thing happened to a little girl, trying to make sense out of this, you know, terribly tragic situation, kind of taking that experience and turning it into a very melancholy, very beautiful, sweet, bittersweet piece of storytelling. You know, a lot of people, to kind of cope with these kind of experiences, I feel like, try to find sense and reason into why these kind of things would happen. Taking your experiences, taking things you see around you in the world and turning them into art to try and make sense of them. I don't know. I feel like it's just like a natural reaction that some people have, that artists have, you know? Then to somebody like me who is very much a secondhand observer of these sort of events, it, you know, the tragedy never had any impact on me or my life at all until I read about the little excerpt on my computer screen. And even, like, reading it doesn't really affect me, right? But it's giving me context as to, you know, the backstory behind the song, the motives, and perhaps a glimpse into the mind of the person writing it. So for me, it's just an enjoyable song, and I like it, you know? I'm not going to pretend that I was so deeply affected by reading about the accidents that it changed my experience in any way. But it did. But only in that it gave me a better appreciation for the song. It's different for me, someone who's experiencing and enjoying it, than for the person who wrote it and is performing it, because for them it's like working through something. You know, even for myself, if I'm writing a song or something, right? The experience that somebody gets when listening to something I write is not going to be the same as what I experienced as I was going through the experiences and as I was writing it myself, for myself, for me to understand. The experience of the artist and the consumer can be very different. It's basically what I'm saying. And that's fine. I think that's okay. You know, not everybody has to experience what I did when I was writing through my music. And I don't need to experience what these guys did when they were kind of working their way through this. Now that I know the specs where I can appreciate it, and I think maybe just enjoy it more, and maybe sympathize a bit more. Again, that's a long way to say that I really enjoy the song, and a great suggestion. So thank you very much. I'm excited to check out more of this band, because I'd never heard of them before. And yeah, that's about it, you know? Cool. That's a bit for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, make sure to like it. If you like the channel, make sure to subscribe. Of course, everybody have a great day. I'll see you some other day. And yeah, you know, Junio out. Bye.